How we doing, guys? Just getting a couple things ready here for our double feature two painting class tonight. Feeling a little bit better, so thought we'd tackle two tonight. We are in for it. Get your popcorn, get your snacks ready for a double feature. I don't know if you guys are familiar with the drive-in, but we have a pretty sweet drive-in theater in Northern Michigan, and it's always a double feature. So that's what we're doing tonight. Tonight's theme, as I posted earlier, is about yellow. Yellow is a friendship color. It's an uplifting color. A lot of after holiday letdown, and people got their New Year's resolutions going, and hopefully those are going great. So this is going to be an uplifting night. We're going to try a couple new things. We're going to start a piece and then let that dry as we start our second piece, and then come back and finish the first one. That's how we're going to kind of do this. So thanks for joining me. I think I got some things figured out, got the music going. It'd be nice and relaxed tonight. This is therapeutic for you guys. It's therapeutic for me. I look forward to this time of the day when I can just dive in and get going. So tonight we are going to do two different pieces. We're going to do a 16 by 20 just white canvas. The second piece we're going to do is going to be a 12 by 24 of more of a landscape. So we'll be getting to that in a little bit. So again, questions, thoughts, anything you guys want to chat about, go ahead and put them in the comments or send me a direct message. I will get to those at the end. So we're going to dive right in here and get rolling. So what we are going to do tonight, I know some of you might have seen the purple, all purple landscape, cityscape, excuse me, that I did the other night. We're going to do one that incorporates black and white and the gray tones that we did, as well as yellow. Our theme for tonight with a yellow girl. And then we're going to be doing a sunset palm tree Hawaiian type thing. I'm going to try something different. I've not done palm trees before. So we're going to try that together. So again, we're all about learning new experiences. Super fun stuff. So we're going to get going here. And again, questions, concerns, thoughts, anything like that, feel free to put those in the comments. I will get to those as soon as I can. So I'm gonna bring you guys a little bit closer. Pretty soon I will be having a much better setup here. So you're seeing me in the infancy phase here, and we're just gonna kind of learn this stuff together. And we're gonna get better as we go, right? So again, we're gonna be doing kind of a blend of yellow and white. So we're gonna just start with that nice, big, thick white line. I got a 2-inch brush here. On my plate, I have black, white, and yellow. Hey, my high school colors. All of you former Glen Lake Lakers out there. I saw a couple of you jump on there. Go Lakers. Any Steelers fans out there? We're starting this one off fun. We got globs of paint. We got parts of our brush falling off, so. All right, so we're gonna get this nice and thick, because we are going to throw in some, we're going to throw some yellow in here and kind of blend that just a little bit. We're going to do some yellow rain, which is kind of apocalyptic, I guess, but we're going to say it's a happy sign. So we got that white going. We're going to dab just a little bit of this yellow right on the end here, kind of come in through here, nice and light, just the ends, make that kind of a yellow rain. And again, this doesn't have to be uniform. It doesn't have to be perfect. A little darker. Cool, we're gonna go in a couple spots here and make this a little bit darker. Yeah, we are gonna get some yellow streaks, on some heavier yellow in some areas. So again, we got a couple of different brushes that we're going to use. We got this 2-inch brush. We got another 2-inch brush that we're going to use for our black. sure we're getting this all the way down to the bottom, because we want to make sure we're going to be using that reflection. So cool. Right, I like it. Get a little bit more yellow in that middle. See, I like it kind of streaky. If you guys take a look, it's got some darker streaks to it, some lighter streaks to it. If you ever look outside and it's raining, I mean, 10 feet from where you're standing, it might be raining heavier. You might see some sunlight coming through. Who knows? I'll post a picture here in a little bit. Today was such a weird weather day in Michigan. Started snowing like crazy. And then an hour later, it's sunny and all the snow's gone. So, super random. All right. Grab some black, we'll get that going. Again, we want those edges to start with a different brush, just black. We're gonna get that edge nice and black. Hey, it's so funny, I had some Enya going on there, and of course Coldplay jumps on. And of course we know their song, Yellow. How about that? I totally did not plan that. I know you guys are thinking I probably did, but random. Part of the creative process, I guess.
Alright. Grabbing that in here.
Again, you'll see I painted the edge of that just to give it a better finish. It doesn't look sloppy. If you're hanging it on the wall, it'll look a lot better. You don't need to frame it. Appreciate you guys being with me tonight. Super excited. Trying two pieces tonight. So we're gonna kind of hustle through some of this just to get two pieces in. Again, we got edges black. We're gonna go right back into that white with that black and some yellow. Okay, so we got a smudge of white and yellow. Look at that, that's pretty. White, yellow, black. We're right into this odd area here. We're gonna get some grays, some gray tones right back into that yellow. We're gonna work our way from one edge to the other. Picking up some of that yellow as we go. We don't want to go right back into that black again, because we're going to come over here and it'll leave it super streaky. So what I do is, we had black on this edge of the brush towards the black here. We're going to spin the brush around when we come over here, because the black's on that side. So again, we still have black on the brush. We're grabbing some white, we're grabbing some yellow. Got a good blend going there. Come right in here. Just gonna fill in some of that black. Pick up, turn it into some gray. With that transition period. Oh yeah, we're getting streaky. Love it. All right. Looks like I got some yellow rain going now. Just recently, right before I went on, had somebody send me some of their trees that they did. I was so impressed. That is so cool. You know, one of the questions I always say is, you know, somebody asked me, do you like these? My question right back is, do you? So if you are proud of your work, that is all that matters. I will give you helpful advice if that's what you're asking for. But I want you to be proud of your work. So as long as you are proud of it and you're happy with it, then that's all that matters. So keep painting, keep trying new things. Get a little more yellow. This is just kind of a personal preference of what you guys want, how you want it to look. When we did just black and white, it's easy just to go with some gray tones kind of over top of this and blend it. But when we have a third color, that gets kind of muddy and you don't really know where we're going with some of this. And that's just kind of personal preference and what you want to do with that. So I'm actually going to go right back to this lighter brush, because we're kind of getting a little muddy there. Grab some more white and yellow. I'm just going to kind of go over this. Cool. All All right, so we're getting some different tones here. This is cool. All right, I am gonna get a little more yellow, and we're just gonna kind of do this. Don't super recommend this unless you've tried it a couple times, but we want a little bit more yellow in here. So we are gonna really go a little nuts with that yellow. Remember, this is going to be our background of our cityscape. We want that kind of dark right to the edges and really bright right in the middle. So, cool. All right, how we doing? Hey, we've still got 36 people hanging out for our double feature. Right there. Highlighted right in the middle. Alright, so this is going to be pretty thick. We got quite a bit of paint going on here. So we're going to let this dry while we jump to our next piece. What's that look? A little more here. Blend this just a hair. Yeah, I like it. Get some moodiness to it. Listening to here. Does it feel the same? Funky jams. Okay. Cool. Alright, let's get a little more. This is all just kind of a fun little experiment. As this is drying, it starts to look a little different. So just remember that. Nice long strokes all the way from one end to the other. So you don't have weird pickup pieces, the brush kind of comes. Try to get as straight as we can. Cool. A little bit more of a blend here. Cool, I like it. So we are going to set this aside, put it on our drying rack, and let this dry. And then we're going to jump into, actually, you know what? No, we're going to do the buildings. Switching plans. Hey, I'm in charge, so that works. All right, so get these brushes out of the way. All right, so we got to get a horizon line. So we get a little bit of white on our palette knife. I'm just going to kind of come in here. Bust out a horizon line. Awesome. Hope you nail it the first time. So again, we want from the center, we want to leave open as if it's a distant road that we're kind of walking towards. And we're going to put the buildings off to the side. So we're grabbing mainly white. And then, so you can see, we got mainly white on the palette knife. But we're going to put a dab of yellow in there, just on one edge, to kind of give it just a highlight. And we just go right through it. Cool. I like it right off the bat, first one. Okay, same thing on the other side. A little bit different spot where the yellow is. If you can see it, pull it back. It's right in the middle. So we'll make it a little bit higher. Don't quite know what we got there. A little piece of the plate, maybe. All right. Cool, a little more white. And just a hint of black. So we got all three colors in there. Oh yeah. Now we're getting there, that looks cool. You can try to get these as straight as you can. When you get a lot of paint underneath your palette knife, it sometimes will wobble and kind of flow a little funky, but okay, get some yellow in there, this one. Oh, cool. And feather that palette knife so you got it flat, and then you're just gonna, you're not gonna really scrape it. You hear me scraping it at the end, that's because it's sharpening off, but you're gonna float that so that you have paint all the way along. It's like buttering toast. You don't put all the butter on one edge of the toast and then leave the rest. You're gonna want it to kind of feather all the way across that. Cool. A little more yellow on this one. Cool. Take a little more black as you get closer to the edge. Ooh, sure, busting it out. Okay, so a little darker again. Maybe just black and yellow, no white. These edges. Cool. Now, something I wanted to touch on a little bit too is I know a lot of you're going through some rough times right now, and you're looking for some therapy and that sort of thing. This, I'm telling you, art is a good therapy. So whether you write poetry or you're painting or drawing, taking photos, it's a great thing to get into as far as taking care of yourself. And get that, do some self-love, some self-therapy, and help each other out, you know, lean on some friends. Because you never know. I mean, some people could be going through some stuff that you have gone through before, and you can be a help to them. So, art is not the only community in which we can help each other. So, well, help each other out. Lend a friend a hand or an ear. You know, sometimes somebody just wants to be heard, and you can be that person for them. So, help each other out. All right. Cool. Yeah, there we go. We are getting some cool blends right here, guys. You know, I've done these, I don't know how many times, and they're always different because you never are gonna get the paint to mix the same, and that's super fun because then they're never the same, and it's always an experiment. We're having fun with this. We're having fun. You guys gonna try this? It's really easy. Don't let the fact that it's a palette knife intimidate you at all. It's something completely different for a lot of you folks. It was different for me when I first tried it, but totally worth it. There are times when you can use it in other pieces that you're doing. All right, so this is starting to get a little muddy here. I got a couple more pieces, so I'm throwing a little bit more yellow paint down. Just because yellow's our highlight color. So we're just gonna kind of come in here on some of these drab looking ones and throw some yellow over top. Oh, yeah. Yep, you know when you nail it and you're just like, yeah, feeling it now. That's the good stuff then. Oh, yep, cool. Sorry, I'm feeling great today. Now I'm just under the weather for a little while. And took a nap, got some vitamins in me, had some good food, and now we're there. Awesome. What do you guys think? Here, I'm gonna just give you a little close-up on this. But, there, we got some yellow. That looks super cool, huh? See how it's different? We added a little bit of yellow over top of some of those grayer buildings and just really added some pop, some highlight to it. So we're gonna put our horizon line back in there. And get some more white. So we're gonna get that palette knife cleaned off. Woohoo, clean palette knife. I just keep a rag kind of close by so I don't have to run to the sink and don't have to run to the sink and clean it off, just wipe it off. All right, so a little white. Put a little more yellow in here. So we're gonna put some yellow and white highlights in there, as well as black along the edge. So let's come back in with that horizon line. Cool. All right, and then we're gonna start getting our highlights in there, and then we're gonna and we'll put the girl in a little bit. So we'll get started on our second piece here in a few minutes. We're gonna do white right in the middle, because it is the brightest of our highlights. So we're just kind of dabbing some white in there with this palette knife, right along that horizon line. Like it's really kind of flooded the streets. Oh man, we're getting some uplifting jams now. You guys can dance too if you want. That's an expression of art. So if you're watching along and feel so inclined, that'd be awesome. Oh man, we're having fun tonight. I appreciate you guys being there. Yeah, we got 34 people still hanging out. So we are having fun tonight. We're doing a double painting with yellow. Trying some new things. We are gonna try some palm trees here in a little bit. Excited about that. They are very easy. So I say that now on. Hopefully I can follow up with some good looking palm trees. So alright, we are just ready for some yellow. Some of these ends are a little thick of paint, so we're just gonna kind of feather them out. So we want to transition this to yellow. See, we got the yellow highlights in the buildings up here, so we're going to want to have those kind of mimic down here. Since we are using some color, we want to use some of the appropriate highlights for the buildings that we have. We'll just kind of take a look at the top side of this and kind of mimic some of where those might be. Same thing over here, we're going to have quite a bit more of yellow highlights where these yellow buildings kind of formed at the top. Girls just want to have fun, huh? This is a throwback. Artists just want to have fun. Yeah, that's right. We're just going to play around here with that. And we're throwing some white ones in there. The yellows, transition that. Got some yellow highlights there, so mimic that in the water. Alright, now let's not forget about the black highlights, or low lights if you will, all the way to the edge, right up into that horizon line with some black. Kind of muddy that up just a little bit. If you're looking at this from a distance and you see that horizon line, it is not going to look real sharp. It's going to be kind of floody muddy with different colors, and you're not really going to tell what is that horizon there, or is it a little further. So again, making sure these lines stay a little bit wider or further apart as you get closer to yourself, or further away from the horizon if you will. That's that dimension. All right, so we had a little streak of yellow there, so looks kind of funky, didn't look realistic, so we're just gonna kind of cover that up with the black. Okay, a couple more black highlights on that side. Right up into that horizon line. Muddy that up just a little bit. Gray it up. It's not just a stark black line up there, which looks super not real. But we don't want it to be white either, because it is kind of hidden from the horizon, where the sunlight would be coming from back there behind those buildings. So it is in a shadow. Cool. A lot of black there. Alright, how are we doing, guys? Still got some 33 people. Thank you guys for hanging out. You're gonna get the double feature here in a second. We're about to start the second piece, which I'm super excited about because I haven't done the sunset once before, so. Alright, wiped it off, back into this white. I want to make sure to get a couple more of these highlights, yellows and whites. Down towards this end here. Can't just leave the painting unfinished down here. Cool. All right. I like it. Cool. We're going to set this aside, put this on our drying rack so that we can get this area nice and dry, so when we come in with our yellow girl, it doesn't blend. And we're going to start on our next piece. I'm going to wash my hands really quick. Bear with me just so I don't get that canvas dirty. Hang tight. I'm still coming. All right. Very good. All right. So again, second piece, we have a 12 by 24 canvas. Good for horizon photos, landscape photos. It's here. Another plate. All right. So again, we talked about doing yellows. So we're going to have some yellow. We're also going to be using some orange. Some vermilion and some burnt sienna. So those are the colors I'm going to be using, primarily the orange and the yellow, since we are using this as our theme tonight. All right, so let's get this one rolling. Should have had these already. Cool. All right. We're gonna get this yellow. All right. So again, we're gonna just kind of cover this canvas with our yellow. So we're gonna use a 2-inch brush here. And I'm just gonna use this cheaper, wetter. And we're just gonna cover the canvas. Yellow. You can see that some of the yellows are going to be a little bit different in thickness and in brightness and vibrancy. We're going to be kind of fading in some orange on this side, so I'm not super concerned with getting this like really covered all that well, but this is going to be our yellow side, more or less where our sun is going to be, so we're going to want to make sure that we got a good flow of yellow on this side. And again, we're going to have kind of some land down here, so not a huge issue to make sure that that's all covered, but we do want to get this nice and yellow up here. So I'm using a little bit thicker of acrylic paint over top of this, just to kind of thicken this up just a little bit in some areas. We're gonna make sure we get this edge. All right. Apologize for the ad that we gotta listen to here, but long strokes. Make sure we don't have any chunky spots in there. And let's finish this out over here.
To learn more, visit amazon.com/nod. That's
amazon.com/nod. Nice. Okay. Yellow, just like the theme we talked about for tonight. It's all yellow. So, there we go. I'm not going to worry about this bottom edge right now because we will come in with a darker color that we're going to be using. So we have some yellow on that one. Come in with are orange. I might even throw in just a hint of some red in a second here once we get this kind of starting to blend. Matter of fact, let's see where we're at here with this vermilion here. Cool. All right, so we have our orange in our vermilion, which is more of a red color. We're gonna grab a 1.5 inch brush here. It doesn't necessarily have to be that size. Could be a little bit smaller, bigger. Doesn't really matter. Personal preference. So we're gonna work this orange from this side in because we want our sun to kind of be on this side. Our trees are gonna kind of come through that. So we're gonna work this in from this side. Thicker here. And I'm just gonna put these in some thicker spots because we want it to kind of look, the sky's not all uniform, you know, so. Cool, all right, now let's blend this. Over some areas will be a little bit. Again, we got these middle beams of these canvases. Sometimes it's a little funky. You'll see a line in there. Okay, I'm gonna make sure this edge is nice and dark because it is the furthest away from the sun source. We'll work some red in there too, but okay. We're gonna have a little bit of a water reflection down at the bottom, so we're gonna throw some of this in. Again, I'm holding this up because I'm try to keep that center beam from being hit from this orange paint over top of the yellow. Wonder why we're picking up black flecks in there. I think it's from some wet paint on the table here, so make sure your area is clean. Alright, cool. So now we're gonna kind of work this in. We're gonna fade this in to where we're gonna have a sun. The brush still has some orange on it, but it's pretty dry. So we're gonna work this in. Don't worry too much about these brush strokes on this side because we're gonna kind of go over those again in a second. But we're just gonna kind of to where we're gonna have almost a circle-ish, working this orange towards the center. And then we're just kind of lightly brushing over top. I'm gonna grab from the edge, looking over top of this. And just fading through this yellow area where this is kind of where our sun was gonna be. All right. Now we're covering up those old brush strokes, bringing that paint over from the side. Cool. So we got a hazy sun. It's kind of poking through. You don't really see a whole lot of chunky brush strokes in there. All right, we're gonna come in with some red here in a second. Just want to make sure this all looks pretty uniform. A little more orange that way. You guys digging this so far? Still got about 35, 36 folks. Appreciate you guys sticking around for this. This is kind of thinking about what we wanted to do, something different. I don't want to do the same thing every night, so people getting bored and that kind of thing. So there's something different every night. We'll try. Yes, it may be a tree, but it's going to be a different tree. Tonight we're going to be doing some palm trees. Cool. So we got a little sun there. Let's dab a little of this red. We're going to we're gonna turn the brush sideways. So you can see there, we're gonna be just kind of streaking some of this red in. From the edge, because it is darker, further away from the sun, so we're getting this edge with that red. We're just gonna kind of pull this across. It doesn't have to be uniform, because these are kind of like faded clouds on the side. But if you guys can kind of see, oh yeah, it shows up good. Cool. And then even darker down towards the bottom. Pulling these across. Cool, yeah. I like it. Make it your own. No paintings that you're gonna do are really gonna be the same. So you can try something different in each one. So again, this is gonna be water down here, so we're gonna get this kind of mimicked with the sky. And our horizon line is gonna be down here. So if this is where the horizon line is gonna be, we want this to mimic that, vice versa. Okay, so we're starting to get a little dried out here. So we're gonna kind of be real careful. That's kind of how that goes. Okay, cool. Pull some of that just a little bit further. And then we're gonna dab just a little, and we're gonna come on the side. Digging it. Oh man, that's cool. I have not tried this before, so you guys are experiencing this with me. So I appreciate that. This is gonna be kind of where our horizon line is, so I'm gonna make this red line kind of go all the way across. Because these are going to be grabbing some yellow, because that is going to be our reflection from the sun. Just kind of hit that a little bit. Might want to do that a little bit thicker. We'll just actually put the paint directly on there. Thicker, a little better paint. Alright. Okay. There we go. Now we got it. Got some glow in the water. Cool. Alright. How are we liking it so far? Looks pretty cool. Looks like it's on fire. I like it. We do have a little yellow still on here. I want to pull up into the sky and throw some highlights to it. Right across in front of this. Dig it. Try something a little different I have not done before either, as far as making some clouds. So we're gonna grab some white. All right, so bear with me here. I just grabbed an oval brush here. It's got a little dollop of white on there. We're just gonna kind of come in here with some clouds. I'm just dabbing it right now because we're gonna kind of come in with a little different brush. Here in a second, kind of highlight some of this. different. Cool. So this is going to be highlighted. Now remember, at the sun on this side, so the highlight on these clouds is going to be, you know, to this side here, following kind of the same thing we do with our trees. I'm going to make sure that highlight's on the one side, not uniformly all the way through. Kind of twisting and turning as I go so that you don't have the same pattern. Bottoms are going to probably be a little bit more flat than the tops are, so just kind of remember that as you go. Cool. All right. Some of these are darker underneath some of these. Cool. All right. We got some puffy little clouds in there. Cool. Thank you guys for hanging out. We still got 30. Plus, folks, now we are going to get into doing some land and some trees. All right, we are going to grab some black. Get these trees in black. All right, so I'm going to dive right in here and kind of work some some palm trees in here. So we get a little dollop of black on the end of that, and we're going to start at the top. Kind of get palm trees are kind of bent and wispy, so we're going to start nice and narrow and then thicken it up as we get towards the bottom. And we can adjust this a little bit as we go. The second one we're going to have is going to kind of come here. It's gonna come together a little thicker at the bottom. All right, so I'm gonna grab this thinner brush here. Excuse me, I just showed you the wrong end. This thinner brush here, we're gonna kind of frame in the ends of these a little bit more, just so that they kind of come to a little bit thinner of a point. This brush was a little bit thicker than I wanted, so. You can find a thinner square headed brush like that, you might be able to get a better point. This one was a little bit older of a brush, and I think it just kind of got a little wacky. So we're going to kind of play with this a little bit and get the form that we really want to these trees. Okay, cool. A little thicker than I wanted, but hey, that's the first time for everything. So as far as the palms go, you can get black back on your brush here to flatten it out just a little bit. Some people use a fan brush. We're gonna try to do this here with this brush. Now, the first couple palms you're gonna wanna do is kind of hugging the tree on both sides. So this one we're gonna kind of go here, wisp down. All the way down. Same thing with this one on this side. Again, wisping. Picking that brush towards the end is going to give you the little tips of the palms. I'm going to do another one up here. Just kind of play with it. And one more off the top here. A little bit more black. We're picking up some of the sky there. We'll redo this one. It's a little dark. And we'll go back on this one. There we go. Cool. All right. What do you think? Does that look real? Alright. I'm happy with it. Again, if you're happy with your own art, it's a good day. The ones at the top are going to be a little shorter and curved at the end. It's going to give you a little difference in distance. Palm trees, kind of come in here with some ground. Kind of a beach area there. Cool. All right, then we're going to kind of come in with some of that orange and yellow and highlight these trees. Cool, we got a beach going. Cool, now here's something you too you can do if you want. You can kind of come in here. A little bit of yellow and white, if you want. We did have a horizon line in here. Is, you know, kind of highlight some of this water where the sun is. Just probably should have done that before the trees came through, but it's all personal preference, you know. Just, and it's fine. We'll go over that with black, but it's kind of yellow and orange. Some of these highlights in here. Our horizon line, if you will. Oh, cool. And it's kind of going downhill a little bit, so we're going to pump this up just a little bit. I like it. Get some more whites, some yellows. Yeah, it's Hawaii, man. There's like waves and stuff coming in, so we want to make sure that we're showing that in our painting. Again, I just went over that tree a little bit. We probably should have done these first, but it's okay. You can come in over top of it with this, and we're good. See? Cool. All right, I'm going to put a little more yellow down here so we have some more for highlights. And what do you think? Still got almost 30 folks still hanging out. We got to finish our other one. Oop. A little darker, isn't it? It's brighter. Cool. And some orange. orange and white and yellow kind of all together. It's highlights. Just gonna throw a couple in here. Probably more so towards the sun than anywhere else. Probably should have done this before I did the trees, but it's okay. Kind of get the idea here.
Are you looking for incredible clothes at an affordable price? At Good Friends, we're obsessed with craftsmanship.
And we'll adjust these too, so quality construction, you'll be able to see.
Super precise fits with all the details you want. Discover exceptionally soft shirts and chinos with
shorter ends here.
Shop Good Friends exclusively at Amazon.
With Amazon Music Unlimited, you can listen to any song, anytime. Access 50 million songs whenever you want. Just ask, try Amazon Music Unlimited.
All right, so again, we should have come in here before and done that before we did the trees, but so we are just widening the base of these trees out just a little bit, because if you've really seen palm trees up close, they're really narrow as they go up towards the top and thicker towards the bottom. So we're going to highlight these just a little bit with some yellow and white where the sun is there. So you're going to get just a little bit of that highlight on that side of the tree. This one's going to be on this side of the tree. So we got yellow and white on our brush right now, highlighting these. You can go into the ferns and stuff too if you'd like to, and the palms, and do those as well. Maybe like one of these. One of these main ones. Really kind of throw a highlight in there. Yeah, that's kind of neat. Down one of the boughs, that center line. Adds a little something to it, doesn't it? There we go. I like that. Cool. Nice. I like that. All right. Make sure we're getting all the black on this side nice and thick. So that's the shaded part of the tree. Put a little yellow in there. Cool, we got our palm trees, so I think we're about ready to sign this bad boy. Cover up some of that highlight. Pull it down into the ferns a little bit. Cool, all right. Sign this one. This one's done. Let's throw a small signature in this one because we have a ton of room. That P doesn't look all that great. So, there we go, folks. We got our Hawaiian palm trees. People say I'm only doing, you know, our nice oak trees or whatever they are, but we just use palm trees in there, and they look pretty good. All right, so we are done with this one. We're gonna set this one aside and pull back our yellow cityscape, which is still drying. We're going to put our girl in here, so we want to grab our yellow. We don't want any other colors than the yellow, so try to keep that away from the orange, from that other, I like to reuse place and stuff, so All right, so we are gonna get a yellow girl going here. All right, so she is going over here. That's a little bit fresher. See, it's pulling some of that black from the background. Which is fine for the backside of her jacket because it's gonna be, this is where it's gonna be the shadow. But we really don't want it on the front side of the jacket. Okay. Just framing in this with the palette knife. It's kind of her jacket. It's a windy day. It's really kind of lost in the city. So we can kind of get fun with the wispiness of her dress and her raincoat, if you will. So we're just using the tip of that palette knife. We're flattening it out in the middle and then tipping it out towards the end to kind of give us a little bit of a wispy end to it. Shows movement, makes it look really kind of windy, and just kind of however you feel like the frame of her would be. And once you get kind of satisfied with that, we'll move into her hair. So we're going to use a different palette knife for her hair. Going to use this round one because I couldn't find a pointy one, and that's fine. It's really just going to kind of fill that in just a little bit. You don't want to go too high because we're going to be putting the umbrella up there as well, and we don't want to get as much black in it as we would if we were really drawing her head totally. So again, we're kind of wisping some of this down into the jacket and out into the air. Cool. So again, this is just kind of now I got a little yellow in there, so we're just gonna kind of come in with this black again over top of it, fill that in. We wanted some longer hairs kind of coming down. We turn the brush sideways, or excuse me, the palette knife sideways, to get that effect. So flat in the thick parts, and we spin it sideways to get that effect of pulling it longer. There we go. I like it. Staying with the same color, the same black, same knife. And we're going to kind of do her boots here. So where you figure the middle of her head is probably where her legs are going to be coming down. So that's where you'll want to start, the middle piece of yours. And we still got about 25, 26 folks. Again, I'll get to your questions and everything towards the end. When I do get a chance to sit down and look at them all. So we'll thicken these up just a little bit.
They said goodbye to the land. The drink is instant, but the guy just talks.
Cool. I like that. Now, she looks kind of odd, right, because her head's really short, but that's because we're going to put the umbrella over top of it. We don't want to use all that all that black on her hair to go into the where we're doing the umbrella. There, that's what we're getting at. All right, so we're going to put her here and here, and then we just kind of figure there's art. I'm start filling that in with some paint and moving that around. A lot different using a palette knife than using a brush. It's more like buttering toast. Oh man, we got way far out there. So we're gonna make a nice big umbrella. See, if we'd actually gone all the way up with her hairline, we'd have been getting a lot of black paint in there, really messing it up. So make sure we don't do that. Kind of thinking ahead. We're just kind of bringing some of this down, adding the little loops at the bottom of her umbrella. Gonna get into that black a little bit, gets funky, so you want to wipe your palette knife off when you come back to your plate so you're not transferring that black back in there again. Right back over top of that, so you're getting some black. Make sure we go over top of that. Sometimes it's unavoidable. These ones take a long time to dry because you got some thick paint in here. All right. We're close. It's okay to have a little black on this side because this is where the high, that low light's gonna be, and then fade it as we get closer to the highlighted side. So we're gonna need some white in this one. Highlight is from the sun being on that side. We're gonna throw some white down on her dress. The edges. Cool. Let me dig it. Like it a whole lot, you know, with wherever those highlights are, you can kind of just fade over top of it with a flat part of your brush. All right, so I think we're ready for some of the yellow in the water. Almost running out of yellow here. Go back in and get some. You guys watch me long enough, you know that I don't really run out of colors a whole lot because I usually put way too much on my plate. Not tonight. We are buzzing through this yellow, and rightly so. We just did a sunset. Now this yellow girl. Cool. Yeah. Digging it. Excuse me. All right. What do we think, huh? You cool with that? I like it. I think it's time for a signature. Maybe I can do a better P this time.
There we are, folks. We just knocked out two pieces.
Kind of an aerial view of that one. So we got our yellow girl with our yellow rainy sky background dripping all over our yellow buildings. And it's moody, it's lovely, it's therapy, it's positive, it's uplifting, it's all of those things wrapped into one. So we have got her right to the end. Some of you guys hung out with me the whole time. I appreciate that. We got 16, 17 folks still on. We just busted out two paintings in, what, an hour? Give yourself a round of applause for that. I like the pieces we did tonight. You know, the kind of should have done something different on that one with as far as getting the highlights down in the water first and then doing the trees, but I got excited. I want to do those trees. So with something different. I appreciate you guys watching. Any questions, thoughts, concerns, anything. Hi, Mom. My mom loves yellow. Hope you're feeling better, Mom. Reach out to a friend. Yellow is a friend color. Reach out to them if they're having some trouble. Be a friend to them. Lend an ear, lend a shoulder. Go paint with them. Go draw with them. Take them for a walk. Whatever might help. Just be positive. Be loving towards each other. Send me your photos. Send me your ideas. Send me your thoughts. I want to see them. Again, we're going to show you these couple of pieces here at the end. So this one might run, so I don't want to hold it up too long. It's really bright. Yeah, let's do this. There we go. Darkened it up. There she is. Our yellow girl in the rain. And then we also have, which is almost dry, our Hawaiian sunset with some clouds in the sky there. Digging that. Got some land in the bottom. Hope you guys like that. This is a 10 by 12. This is for sale. So is the yellow girl. I know this is going to look really awesome on somebody's wall. So let me know what your thoughts are on those. And I'd love to answer your questions after this. I'm going to be uploading these onto YouTube. So you'll be able to see that process if you didn't catch it live here. I'll also have it live on my Facebook page. Go subscribe. Again, have some seats available left for our painting class we're doing in Tustin at Randy's Tavern on the 19th at 3 o'clock. So if you're available in the area and would like to attend, we'll be doing a seminar there. I'd love to see you guys, love to meet you. Yeah, stay positive. Keep doing art, keep helping each other out, and send me all your photos, ideas, thoughts, questions. I'd love to help out. So have a great night, be safe, and God bless.